been really excited to talk to the Bitdefender people about a product called Bitdefender Box. The Nosilla Castaways are very security conscious, so this is, sounds like it might be something right up our alley. I'm talking to Dan Berte right now.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good.
Thanks. What we have here is something that we announced a couple of years ago. This is our second generation product, Bitdefender Box, which is a kind of a hardware security all included for the smart home.
Ah.
So one of the craziest things is people don't realize they live in a smart home yet. That's something that we still kind of figured out and kind of point out.
I have a smart home. I just have cameras and locks and things sprinkled all over. My lights turn on and off for me.
There you go. 27 devices on average per household is that what we're seeing. It's kind of crazy. So,
yeah.
So what we're doing here at CES 2019 is we're using all the experience and all the knowledge that we gathered with this product and unpacking the technology within to make it available to everybody around here. Because if you look around us in the smart home sector, everybody sells a device or another that's connected in a form or shape. So,
right. So what problem does a Bitdefender box solve?
Right. So to oversimplify it, you know, when you install an antivirus on your PC to keep the bad guys out and the viruses out, it's pretty much the same thing, but you know, obviously more complex and so much better. The challenges are for connected devices on the network is that you can't install anything on them. You can't install a software bit on a thermostat to make it secure.
Right.
So the way that this works is we had to go, as a software company, had to go and invent a hardware device, which was totally out of our comfort zone. A device that sits on the network, acts like a firewall or a protection security device. It looks like a multi-level, a multi-technologies and multi-points of security issues that your devices might face.
Okay, so I've already got a firewall on my router, so this is more than a firewall, though.
Yes.
What is it?
A firewall is just really just a set of rules that is pretty static. This is kind of a living creature. This is connected to our cloud, and our cloud protects more than 500 million devices worldwide. We've protected more than 2 million IoT devices just the past few weeks. So,
walk me through a little more how this works.
Right.
So I've got a bunch of cameras. I got a Nest Protect. I got an Ecobee thermostat. They're all going through my router. Where does this go on the? Where does this go in that sequence between my router and my modem and all that? Where does that go?
So you would set this up next to the router. This can also be a router if you wanted it to have like a cabin somewhere, you could install it there. It's a network device, right? So this would sit next to your Comcast or.
So would it be between my router and my modem?
It's a DHCP kind of a setup situation. So it's not really in between. It's kind of becomes the DHCP server in that network.
To stop using DHCP on your regular router.
Right. This becomes the DHCP server, so traffic can go through it, so we can analyze it. And
okay. So you'd have to put your router in bridge mode on the other side of it.
If you prefer to use it that way, yeah. There's a couple of ways that you can set it up. If you had like a high-end router and you wanted to use its capabilities, Wi-Fi capabilities, then you would bridge it. But if you had one of those combo modems from your ISP, which isn't great, then you'd probably want to use this as a Wi-Fi device, and this becomes that Wi-Fi device, so then you don't have to bridge it.
So there's a couple of ways you can set it up. Okay, so how does it protect an IoT device?
It comes packed with Total Security, which is our classic security product for PCs and Macs and Android, so there's that extra layer. And then this on the network, basically what happens is anything that has a browser, right? You click on the wrong link, we'll block that. But then it's also a vulnerability assessment. Basically what that means, you connect a new device to your network, it shows up in an application, in an application called Central that manages Box, and then we run a vulnerability assessment on it. So you know that, for example, that there's known issues with it, like there's a default password or whatever have you, and then you're informed. Now, of course, most of these threats are blocked. So, for example, if you had one of those smart light bulbs like I did that had a Telnet server running on it with a default credentials and an open port, there's no way to find that out. So this would tell you, and then this would block potential attempts for, you know, anomalous connections to that device. Basically what happens is, try to remember the Mirai botnet, right? When basically the bad guys took over a bunch of hundreds of thousands of unsuspecting cameras that people have in their homes, and used them as computing power to attack other services. They took down Amazon and Twitter and a bunch of other services. So Box would pick that up. We'll like, okay, this server, this command center is trying to attack our devices. We'll block those connections and it will prevent, you know, spread of this kind of attacks.
So the information's going to the cloud of what kind of devices I have.
Yes.
And then going through the box, you're pushing down something that's blocking that kind of connectivity for a problem that's with a known device on my network?
Yeah. So it's a mix of things that happen locally and within the cloud for Box. I'm going to give you an example. So for example, the vulnerability assessment is currently done with locally, although we use the same updates from the cloud, the latest. So that's the beauty of, because you asked me about the firewall. That's kind of a set rule that just stays that way. This is a living creature just because it gets those updates every
time. Okay. Well, very good. So Bitdefender Box, where do people go to find out more about it?
Oh, just you go to our website, bitdefender.com/box, or just go to your favorite retailer and you can source it out there, Amazon, Best Buy.
What's the price point on the version 2?
The MSRP is $199 and includes a year of service, a limited number of devices, and then it's $99 a year. But you'll usually find it, there's a deal on it every at all times. So
Well, that's good. That sounds pretty cool. That's not bad of a price to have a little bit of a peace of mind about all the IoT devices in your home.
I appreciate that. We think so too. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.